Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Good morning. Yesterday we talked about, what did we talk about yesterday? We talked about what? Side angle side. Today we're going to talk about angle side angle. So I'm going to highlight that. Just like yesterday's lesson or the last lesson that we dealt with, in this case that the side has to in between the two angles. Okay, so I'm going to use a color ink to mark it. This side has to be in between the two angles. The side has to be in between the two angles. Now, if you don't really know about corresponding angles or corresponding sides, I really highly recommend you to watch the past two videos just to go over it, okay? I have side in between the two angles. So let's not talk too much about it. Let's dig right in. Today is the third lesson, so I'm going to shift a little bit and zoom in. Okay, so I need to know if these two triangles are congruent to each other. If they are, you gotta show a little work. You know, why are those two triangles are equal to each other? First thing, let's label our diagram. So I have one mark on this angle, and I'm looking for the other one that has a one mark. Okay, so these two angles are equal to each other. And I have two arcs on this angle and two arcs on this angle. So that means I have one set. I have one set and another set of those two triangles. I have the two angles down. I do not have the side that I am missing because I know I want to prove it by angle, side, angle. Now I got the two angles. I'm missing the side in the middle. Now let's name these. I have A, B, C, D. In order for me to find out the side has to be in between the angles. The only side that's in between the two angles is the side AC. So that means in order for me to prove it, I need AC to be congruent to line segment AC. AC and AC are equal to each other because the line segment is equal to itself by reflexive. That means angle, we have angle BAC is congruent to angle, the blue angle here, so DAC. The other green angle, we have angle BCA, this angle right here, is congruent to angle DCA, this angle right here. That's how we prove that these two triangles are congruent by angle side angle. So that means triangle ABC is congruent to triangle ADC by angle side angle. All right, I hope that makes sense. Now, let's look at the second example. Before we start anything, let's name all the things, okay? So I have not angle A, B, C, D. Now I'm going to start formatting a little bit more because now you guys should be okay with what to look for. Let's start with this. This is called a two-column proof. We're going to write the given on one side. We're going to write down the reasons on the other side. Okay? Let's do it step by step. Let's look at what's given to us. It's given to us that this angle right here is equal to this angle. So let's quickly write it down. So I have angle ABD is congruent to angle CDB. because of it's the given. Oh my God, it's not the given, it's the statement. Let me erase it a little bit. I said the given. It's actually the statement. Okay. Because it's the given. Now, they tell me that let me switch it to a different color ink. The blue and the blue. Wait, this is the color green. Sorry, a little colorblind. Okay, so it tells me that those two angles are equal to each other. So angle CBD is congruent to angle ADB. Some people are going to say, Ms. Zhang, whoa, this is a lot of work. We're just naming them, okay, honey? We're not doing anything else so far. We're just naming the angles, okay? Now, just like the last example, I need to prove it that these two triangles are congruent to each other. I got two angles here, so that means in order for me to prove it, I need the side BD. So that means I need to say BD is congruent to line segment BD. Why are they equal to each other? It's because the line segment is equal to itself, right? Reflexive. Let's look at it again. I have one set of angles. I have another set of the angles. I got the side in the middle. So that means these two triangles, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle CBD. These two triangles are congruent by angle side. And that's how you write a two-column proof. I know it looks a little odd to some people, but let's just know how it looked like. Okay, I'm not telling you to memorize anything so far, but you have to be mindful how it looks. Now, it tells me that these two triangles are congruent to each other, but you have to give me the reasons and the statements. Okay, like why, which one is equal to which, and why do they have to be equal to each other? This is the proof that I'm talking about. This is the reason. It's like a little puzzle. These two triangles are congruent by angle side angle. I have one set of angle right here. I know that side CD is equal to side CD. CD is congruent to side CD because of reflexive. Now, in order to use angle side angle, I am missing one more set of the angle, but the only set that we are allowed to use is angle side angle. It has to be this angle right here. Angle side angle. It has to be this pair of angles. It doesn't mean that you could use angle Q and angle E, because technically it cannot really go in order. So that means you only could say that angle QCD is congruent to angle ECD. Did you see how I name it? Again, if you're a little confused, remember to pause the video and watch it again, okay? It's fine. So those are the two missing pieces of information in order for me to say that these two triangles are congruent. So let's quickly jump to number two. Okay, I have angle side angle. So according to the diagram, I have two angles given, right? I got the angle K right here with the angle U, and I have the angle L, two arcs, and the angle T. I am missing the side in the middle. The only side, some people are going to be, oh, Miss Hane, this is so easy. I know, right? I know. The only side we are allowed to use are the side that's in between the two angles. The only side that's between these two angles is this side. The only side that's between these two angles is this side. So that means in order to prove its angle side angle, we must say that side KL or line segment KL is congruent to side or line segment UT. And that's the only piece of information that we're missing. Ta-da! That's the end of angle side angle. Remember, all your homework is going to be on paper for this unit. Join me in my Google Meet if you have any questions. I'll see you guys in the next video. Yeah, I know my nails are gross. All right, goodbye.